One, two, three.
Hello!
Hey guys! We're here to watch Vikings, season 3, episode 1, what's the name?
Mercenary!
Mercenary.
Ooh, really?
Mercenary.
Yes. Yeah.
I like it.
Damn, so,
it's a sexy...
Damn, he really
Surge is
Ragnar's the new
Surge is off camera. He's sitting this one out. We're we got some Game of Thrones stuff to edit. It's that time of the year again. We're
and Avatar.
And Avatar. Avatar as well. It's coming,
it's
guys.
It's being edited.
It's being edited. He's skipping out on reactions to get that out. So if you haven't checked out our Avatar reactions or Game of Thrones reactions, give those a click. Mm-hmm. But let's get back to Vikings. Season 3. I'm hyped.
So Ragnar's the new king orc.
He is the new king. Fuck Horik.
King Ragnar.
We flash forward, he's on a cliff right now, just brooding.
Well, he's not even brooding. He's taking in the glory of what is happening to him. He was grinning big.
And you have to think, like, I mean, I know he's ambitious, he wants to keep climbing the ladder, but this was almost King Horik's own doing. You know what I mean? Like, I know Ragnar would have eventually wanted to be king, but I don't think he would have, like, murdered people to get there.
No.
And so it kind of just plays out in his favor that all of this worked out.
In all honesty, I think Ragnar would stay in whatever position he's in as long as his influence was there. As long as his word actually carried more...
Still, though, I think he's always growing, though. Like, he would stay in a position. Because, like, as soon as he became Earl, he was like, all right, networking. Like, he immediately
started... So do you think now going to England, the next thing for him is to create an empire and not just a kingdom?
Well, I mean, they still have to figure out settlement. Like, they still haven't... We still haven't really seen a deal... Mm-hmm. Well, a deal did get brokered. I think they got
mercenaries.
Well, I mean, they got
something
about it,
probably. For
yeah.
Sure.
Okay. Mercenaries. They got hired to be mercenaries to attack Mercia. Oh,
and to breed
shit.
With the princess.
This is gonna be sick.
Oh shit! This is gonna be a lit episode, dude.
Yeah. Okay. In regards to Ragnar winning power, though, I think in like season 1 he said Odin gave an eye for knowledge. He'd give far more. I don't think.
Very true.
I don't think it's just him seeking power or wanting. I think this glow up, if you would, is happening organically.
Yeah, exactly.
Because of his because this is just where the gods are taking him.
Yeah.
To piggyback off of that, going back to the idea of his influence, because like he said, just wisdom and to be able to
really this finish up.
Oh yeah, but to be able to gain this knowledge and be able to expand, he's got to move up in power. Mm-hmm. But if he was able to get Earl on his side, you know, let Earl run the kingdom, but like, hey, man, got these plans. Help me out. Let me accomplish it. Then, you know, I think he would have stayed Earl.
I can see that.
Yeah, like, he's a king now, but he started out a farmer. And
yeah,
his primary concern is he himself.
He's a son of a farmer.
Like, it's his family and his people. I don't.
Yeah, you remember his farm?
Yeah.
It's like a pile of rubble now. But you guys ready?
True.
Yeah.
Let's do it! Season 3!
I see a trickster's weapon cleaves you.
Not one of your prophecies do I understand.
It is the way of prophecy, only to be understood when it has happened. And it is too late to change it.
What?
Good explanation for a prophecy, because that's exactly what they are.
Thank you, Webster.
And will I die?
The wife of Odin has already made a decision. Come back another day. I may tell you exactly the moment of your death.
Man, are they killing her off this season?
Not this season, if they did.
Nah, because every time they're with the seer, man, he like prophesizes some shit, and he said like the trickster's weapon will cleave you.
Yeah.
Well, I'm trying to figure out, yo, how old are
I'm gonna.
Did he say axe or
trickster's? Some, I have no idea.
I think he just said weapon.
Okay.
Power is always dangerous. It attracts the worst. And corrupts the best. God is only given to those who are prepared to lower themselves to pick it up.
Nice.
Damn,
nice guy. I like his new haircut.
Yeah.
Yeah, his whole head tatted up with him.
Yeah, more tats, more times passed.
Okay, so, yo, how old are the Lagertha?
He's gonna be in his 40s.
That's what I'm thinking.
So, last season we found out, I think Bjorn was like 19?
Yeah, 1918.
So they must get married. I mean, he's already fallen in love and shit, so they must get married in the early 20s on this episode. They can't be more than like 40, I would say.
Yeah, I wouldn't imagine. Yeah, maybe late, maybe 39 or something. Early 40s.
Because life expectancy wasn't that great back then. But they are genetically the best of their kind because they killed off all the weak. So I don't know.
I mean, they pulled the Spartan thing. I mean,
let us know in the comments, guys. How old are they here?
Will you come with me to Wessex?
No. Someone has to remain and look after all your territories. You trust me to do this?
Or maybe he's the trickster.
Why don't you offer to marry me, Calf?
I have nothing to offer you. People would assume that sort of marriage out of ambition.
But she proposed to you, Doc.
She did that right there.
Yeah, essentially.
I'm not sure I want you to come with us to Wessex.
I haven't had many hours of training.
But what if you are a child already? If I lost you, then I would also lose my child.
I am coming with you.
Wow. This went from like a hypothetical thing to I'm going now.
She is stubborn. Alright, they're still about the same age, so not too much time has passed.
I would say a couple months have gone by.
Yeah, he's bigger.
Please don't stop playing on our account.
It's like I don't want him to see this because I'm never going to do it with him.
Yeah, that's kind of fucked up, man.
I feel trapped in all this happiness. I feel trapped, Helga.
If you want to leave us, you should leave.
You're too reasonable, Helga. It doesn't help my way.
Perhaps when you get back from Wessex, you will see sense.
Perhaps I will die in Wessex.
He just doesn't feel like he deserves her.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
No, I don't deserve this happiness.
Yeah. That's cool.
Do you love him?
Of course I love him.
Do you love me?
Debatable.
She's gone. Now we can talk. Talk of what, Einar? Of betrayal? Of murder?
Yep.
No. Not with me.
Yep.
Oh, he's walking. Is he walking?
Yeah, he's walking.
What? Yeah.
And he didn't need a cane or anything. He just walked over there.
I don't fucking believe it. I guess it's been 2 years, but come on, man. He got trampled.
Well, sometimes I remember when I could have been a queen.
Oh, you were.
Now look what I have.
You mean me?
Like, no, that one's almost played out, son. A couple years ago, yeah.
She's had it up to here with your shit.
They're talking on the phone.
Good. Let it out, Rubble.
Fuck that guy.
I know you well, my friend. And I know what tortures you. But what choice do you have? I can neither hide from your God nor ours. I suffer from that same dilemma. Only in reverse. We will go together to Wessex. And you will be my Johnny.
The Baptist.
John the Baptist, yes. Wherever you go, I will follow.
Damn, so he's like learning about like the Bible and stuff?
Uh-uh.
What are you doing? I'm following you, John.
Their broship has gotten
way more intense. Like when it left off, it was about a 6, you know. And now it's like almost a flaring 10.
now we're at code 5 clinger.
You cannot understand. I'm so happy. I'm so happy we're leaving.
Is that to symbolize like how styles might change back in that time? Because everybody
is
rocking.
Everybody
is
a little
different haircuts and shit. Yeah.
What have I told you, Doctor?
Very nice. They're sneaking their comedy in, you know?
Yeah, I like it. It's more witty.
Damn, she looks badass.
Oh, Ragnar gave him the look. Did you see that?
I could not stop her. She reminds me of someone else I knew.
Alright, Borun is auxiliary bay. In case Lagertha dies, Borun is my auxiliary bay.
Time to die, Einar.
Damn, he gonna do it himself? I thought he was a little soft.
I want to die with an axe in my hand, as though I had died in battle.
Don't give him an axe.
Yeah.
Surely you won't deny me that.
Yeah,
I think
will. I might.
You give me the axe or not?
No!
This has got to be the stupidest.
If he gives him the axe, this guy
is... Oh, Jesus.
I mean, does he feel that confident in his fighting skills? All right.
I mean, he's not, like, handcuffed or chained or anything?
Nothing.
Your gift was foolish. If you kill an unarmed man, then you really are a coward, like Arthur thinks you are. Would you really kill your own Earl? Persuade your family to support me as Earl, and we will get rid of the woman who usurped your uncle. What does she do for us?
But why isn't your bitch ass out there? Why isn't he out there fucking raping right now?
Because he asked Liger to
let him
stay behind and take care of her shit.
Has he ever been on a raid once?
I don't even know who he is.
What has happened to our people who chose to fight for Marcia?
Unfortunately, the forces of my uncle and younger brother have prevailed. But if you, Ragnar Lothbrok, and you, Lagertha, would join with us, I am sure of victory.
That is not part of our original agreement. In hopes of creating a long and prosperous friendship, I will fight.
In order to establish the settlement here in Wessex, I need the help of one of your leaders.
Yep, skal helpe deg. Og Mikael Hansen.
And you also must stay, Athelstan. You can speak for all sides. We need you. I need you.
Put that creepy ass.
Yeah.
Creepy ass.
Let's
away.
Get in the bathtub, guys.
I rejoice with all my heart to see you again.
Don't translate. Don't you ever leave without telling me again.
I'm well, son.
Thank God.
No kiss.
They told me you were crucified, but you still bear the stigmata of Christ.
It's not a stigmata. You guys straight up put it there.
Like, damn, bro.
It's a
sensitive topic.
These people are thinking he's holier than thou. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. At the wolf ain't having it. You saw that right at the end.
Mom. You stay away.
Look at me. I'm ready for that. I love shaved my head and everything.
And I think you will already be with Chad.
Yeah.
Stay home!
Well, she was just doing it in the pride sense of, I can do it, I'm a free person, I can do anything, I have the choice.
That's gonna get her killed one day.
Tell me about your uncle.
My uncle's name is Britwolf, though he calls himself King Britwolf now. He has no right to do so. He has usurped my crown.
Damn. Stop staring.
Skin to him, outside stop.
Yeah, dude, he's fucking hitting on
her. Eckward swiping right on Lagertha.
Angelic Stona Anna Griffithshire Sailor.
And Fatsaka, huh?
She knows these other compliments.
Gonna dare to find the Kuna.
No man should be such a fool as to trust these things.
No man should trust the word of a woman.
Well, fuck me.
I can't bring myself to trust these pagans. No. My life is crude, primitive, ignorant.
Y'all are actually about on the same level.
It's not possible to imagine a world in which there is both one God and several. One of us must be right.
The Lord saith, I am the way, the truth, the light.
Wouldn't a deceiver say that? You are the way, the truth, the light. You don't have to really say it.
We will soon be in Mercia, and you must fight for me. And if you are victorious, I promise that I shall give you something worth more than land or riches.
He's like, girl, I got 8 sons over here.
She's doing her kegels right then and there. You guys knew you were...
Oh, they're still on the boat. This is cool.
She did
you
say guys... soon.
Yeah, well, I mean, they said they were upriver. I mean...
wouldn't you like... I like it doesn't even phase them. It lands like right next to their face. They're like, yeah, it's cool.
They got the advantage on the ass.
This will be interesting. Yeah, what the fuck? Let's see it.
Show me his hand.
They belong to my uncle, Britwolf.
And that?
Oh, shit.
He's like, man, you told us to bring him.
That is a considerable force, Father. The force is on the right bank, much lower than those on the left. As far as I can see, there is no bridge. There is no way the two armies can easily rejoin.
We attack your own. But stay out of our way.
Send the horn!
Oh, no!
Concentrate the full attack on the right bank!
Nice!
Steel ball!
we're getting some like strategy with our action now. Like they're kind of talking about
yeah,
it, what they're
yeah.
doing.
To hook him up with some of the old school stuff so he can start studying.
Sound the horns!
Oh shit, that is the old boy from Game of Thrones.
Doing shit from that.
They'll get the very tough.
Yep.
Anything.
Lol. Y'all thought you were clever. Hilarious.
Why would we just attack you, my uncle? Why would we fight both of you for that?
Yeah, why would we go after the larger force?
That's what inbreeding gets you, folks. Kick their ass.
Why do you guys have such... Dude, yeah, like, he ain't fucking around. War.
I'm still alive, dog.
That's just a question. What are they doing? How are they getting there? Where's her people at? I don't see how fussy they are.
This is like Vikings Day Normandy, dude. This is tight. We've never seen like it like this. Every battle is like different. It's like a different
scenario.
It's
getting more intense.
Crush him.
Lame.
Let me see one good dude get crushed with a ship.
She's so happy. She's so happy.
That was her first kill in 5 seconds. It's a good shoot.
Floki just kind of like, eh, whatever, y'all. You ain't nothing, really.
She's loving it.
No, she's scared as hell.
Kill him.
Oh! Ooh.
My bad.
Ooh. Wrong guy.
Ooh. It's a good thing I recognized you.
Friendly fire.
That's about as close as it got back in the day, right?
Damn, dude, she's fucking badass.
They're getting put there, he's
getting scared. They know how much they fucked up. They're like, why did we split across the river?
He's like, you can't pass up a good battle scene.
No, you should watch this episode.
Oh, Torsten, no.
Go kill him with it.
Kill him with it.
No!
No, he didn't get him with it. Did he get him with it?
It's a little bit there.
Got him, thank you. Oh, thank God.
Tip of that just got me, old man. They're just like, fuck. Shit.
We're so smart, guys. You know they came up with this plan when they were drunk.
They should have tried to at least start going.
Yeah, they're just like still just big people are. So what do you want to do, boss? Make a call, son.
Oh, he's gonna go swim across.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, if you see that. Lol.
Dynasty Warriors. That's a game.
Oh, get his ass right now.
Didn't even try.
Yeah,
get him in the face.
Ooh, damn, right away. She loved it. Ooh, she just came.
Oh, well, no, she...
This is also supposedly the uncut, but I don't know. It wasn't too gratuitous.
That's the thing, that like the violence, from what I remember, is about the same.
But
that,
well, I mean, the thing, and I just want to comment on her reaction. Cause like
moist as fuck.
Yeah, I don't think. I mean, like, it was one of those things. Like, I didn't want that son of a bitch dead, but
yeah,
that's what had to be done.
Yeah.
Wow. I'm so excited for you guys to see the next episode.
Wow. Okay. So that was season 3 premiere, episode 1, Mercenary. Woo.
That was good.
Whew.
I'm happy. Are you good? Yeah, you are actually high. Like.
I need to turn the AC on. That was fucking lit. I like the cold opening, and I like the abrupt like cutaway at the end there. Because usually it's like battle, and then we have time to soak it up. But this was like,
yeah,
we just
very
got,
different, you know, polar opposites of how it began and ended.
Yeah, we just got done. That was cool. What'd you guys think?
I loved it. There was a little bit more opening up, I feel, of King Ekbar and of O'Girl. You know, she puts off the air of like, I'm super powerful, but you could see at points where just like, you're also trying to live up to a name, I think, more, you know.
Where was King
L.A.?
I think he's back in his place.
He's in back, yeah.
Yeah, we didn't really see him. Yeah, because, I mean, it's been so, with the only way to judge time for me is, for this episode, was Floki's daughter and Ibar. So I'm guessing like 2 years at the most. Like she looked about 2.
No, she looked maybe one at best.
One and a half, 2-ish years.
I would say even maybe...
I think it was just months.
Yeah.
I'm still, like, kind of reeling from the battle sequence. That was awesome. That was
awesome battle sequence.
What the fuck? Sort of kicking ass.
So well, I
they still
like,
have to contend with that other army now. I mean, that's
yeah.
the whole thing. You
but
know,
it's
yes,
funny,
they
didn't even try. I mean, there's nothing they could have done. I mean, that they're...
That was just stupid.
But they didn't even try. But at the same time, it's like you see that happening across the river. It's like, yeah, maybe it's like a bittersweet thing. It's like, I guess we're safe here. But.
Well, I think the line of thinking was if they all crowded on one side of the bank,
yeah,
they could easily get to the other and still get to the land.
Yeah.
It had to be surrounded.
That was such a dumb move on their part, like trying to look all badass. I can get you surrounded.
Why are they just attacking my uncle?
Well,
yeah.
Like, if you think about it, there would be absolutely nothing stopping them from invading Mercia because one side wasn't accessible from the other.
Yeah.
So you had to have troops there. It wasn't
just,
really like a power move. They didn't have a choice.
I just love the look
I,
on
honestly,
the uncle and the nephew's face, like when they were cutting away.
Like, oh,
they're just
coming
like,
to
oh,
us.
This didn't work out. Like, throughout the battle. Like
oh, yeah.
To the final moment where Floki killed him. And
yeah.
He was just like, this isn't how it's supposed to go down. I imagine this going
you know
differently.
They were drunk when they came up with that plan.
Like,
this is so
jiggle.
Smart.
Oh, so one thing I noticed about the writing is...
Ass!
Sorry. Shout out to Serge, by the way. I can tell he's salty about missing this one, but he's
a good one.
He's been hard at work since Game of Thrones started, and we're trying to get out Avatar... Vikings, trailers, there's a lot going on right now, so shout out to my man Serge, leave him some kind words in the comments. But what I was saying is, I've noticed the writing, I feel like they've written a lot more wit to each
yeah.
character,
yeah.
which just fleshes
well,
them
for
out
the
more.
Whole, yeah, for the whole show itself.
They do a really good job with character development
yeah.
and like visual storytelling. Like some scenes are like, spectacular and important, and not
one or two words said, and
or none,
you know, yeah, or none. But there's so much going on with glances and
yeah,
body language.
You get
like,
it,
damn,
like you get
this
it.
Is good, yeah.
Yeah, the writing is definitely better. Everything is better. It's just,
it's yeah,
it's awesome. Yeah, this is one of those shows that just like keeps like going up. I want to binge it so bad.
I'm glad you guys like this.
It's so awesome. This is one of my favorite shows. Like this is definitely top five for me right now. And,
oh,
I'm,
yeah.
and I'm not even caught up.
That's a good show.
Yeah. So, yeah.
Where does Westworld sit on that?
Ooh, that's also in top five, dude. That's
yeah.
a good show.
You talking about ever or current? Like, as of right now?
Bro, I don't know.
I mean, current running seasons. Current running shows.
Okay, current. So, okay, if I'm eliminating... Yeah, then... Oh, yeah, it's definitely in top five. Yeah, top five.
So, Westworld...
Game of Thrones.
Game of Thrones, yeah. Well, I'm guessing Game of Thrones is number one.
Game of Thrones. Well, I don't know if this is in particular order, but Game of Thrones is one. Westworld. Vikings.
You're not alone,
you,
man. You're not alone.
Here.
All right, but let's get back to Vikings real quick and finish this up. So, what else haven't we talked about? Einar and that mystery guy who's
he's the trickster.
He is the trickster, motherfucker, dude. I don't even know his name. Like I don't know. I missed it, obviously.
Yeah, I did too. I don't remember it.
I'll look it up, but I knew something was squirrely there. But Lagertha is smart, though, so I can't imagine that maybe... I just can't imagine her being, like, that taken aback by a guy. You know what I mean?
I don't think that... I mean, Lagertha is smart, but I don't think she's, like, a subtle person with anything. Like,
yeah.
with anything that she does, she's very direct and to the point.
Yep.
And not being a subtle person, you're going to miss out on that trickery of other people.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I think that... Ragnar being extremely subtle, you know, like he knows he's been fucked over a lot in his life, you know, and that
yeah.
is very obvious.
Yeah, there's a lot going on, man. I mean, there was also what's her face? Aslaug. Aslaug feeling salty about Ivar.
Yeah.
But you know what? I mean, and...
Well, not just Ivar, but...
What I'm about
to
say, I absolutely don't agree with today's societal standards, but I'm putting myself in the mindset of a Viking, is like, everybody told her to not keep the baby, and she
yeah.
kind of took that responsibility on herself.
Yeah,
you know,
I mean, because
I mean?
The way that...
And they don't have medical equipment and shit, so it's
yeah.
like, that was a big deal back then.
And
obviously, I'm not... Don't call me a baby killer. I would absolutely
send that baby up for
keep babies alive. You know,
in that society,
we can
yeah.
handle them
now.
Now
in the new society over in Mercia, he could become an educated person. You become, you know, something.
Yeah, it's like they have a whole new world now. So
exactly. So that might give him a place to live, but in the Viking world, no, he's...
But it did seem like it was like Ragnar and the other three sons and then Aslaug and Ibar. So yeah. I think, I mean, they're not too grown up yet, but once they get in their teens, it's going to be like weird. I think he's going to be like that weird brother that like nobody likes.
I think Ragnar does his best to keep him away and from... Whenever he's around, he probably keeps him away from, like, he's like, kids leave.
Yeah, I interpreted it two ways. One, him just being nice, like, he didn't want Ibar to see them having fun when he can't. Sure. But also, I interpreted it as it was just like, oh, Ibar's here. Like, you know.
True. I didn't even think of it in the idea that he's like, he can't run around. I don't really want him to see this.
It was a layered scene. Yeah. Like I kind of felt both, because he is a father. He loves his kids.
He does.
So
yeah.
You know, it was a good scene.
Out of pure love, he would rather his son be dead. That's a pure kind of love, man.
He's gonna leave him a fighting chance.
That's
though.
As unconditional as
well,
you
can. It's the culture. Like, I mean, even the Spartans, when a baby was born, you throw it in a barrel of water. If it fights, you pull it out. If it doesn't, it dies. It's the way the society's just worked. Like, giving a fighting chance, that was your fighting chance.
Yeah, it's fucked up.
You were born with some sort of deformity.
And then... What about, so there was also Floki's scene where he was like, you know, kind of what you were saying, he doesn't feel like he deserves the happiness he has. But he is a family man now. But Helga is like totally a different type of chick. Like, she does not put up a fight at all. It's like, if you want to leave, that's fine.
You're too good, Helga.
You're too good to me, babe.
You're too good to me, babe. And then on top of that, he had what he was saying mainly to Bjorn and with Rollo at the campsite, mm-hmm. you know, when they were talking about women and such. Torsten would just happen to be there, and they, at the end of it, they were kind of like, you know, congrats to you, Torsten, you know, but...
If he feels tied down.
Yeah, especially, and Rollo is just hurt now, because after denying Siggy's affection for years, now he's kind of like, but I need you, babe.
Yeah. Yeah, Siggy's had it up to here.
Yeah,
She looked like in that scene. She looked like the evil stepmother from Tangled. Didn't she?
I've never seen Tangled.
Didn't she? A little bit.
Shut up.
Well, Hannah, right? Hannah. All right, guys. I think we covered everything. Is there anything anybody wants to
know? No, I mean, Thorne's a badass. They're in Mercia. Lagash is never gonna have a baby.
Forgot about the word.
Might get murked over by old fuckboys over in Switzerland.
Didn't he just say he was gonna like nick her?
He said a weapon that will cleave you. So that sounds.
The trickster's cleave is
cleave is a. That's
no,
nice.
He said that, and then I see a trickster who's, or I see a weapon.
But that's not. No, that's not necessarily the moment over death, because then she asked, "How will I die?"
Yeah.
And he's like, "The gods haven't told me that yet."
Yeah.
So maybe she'll.
She's just gonna get fucked up.
So we know she. We know she's safe. So.
I mean, if Rollo's made it this far, Lagash.
What is? This is. If that's historically accurate, if he just, like, walked away from that, what the fuck? Like,
with that surgery back in the day?
Yeah.
He was trampled by a horse.
His like pelvis must have been crushed. Yeah. Like, bones must have been crushed, dog. Like, there's no way that healed efficiently. There's just no way.
In a matter of months.
Yeah, that's years of physical therapy. And I mean, Bruce Lee broke his back, and it took him, quite a while to get back on his feet. He did create a martial arts.
That
he
was
did
awesome.
It,
so Floki and Seer, they both made their appearances today.
Yeah.
Samir, shout out to you again. All right, I think that was it, right?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
Okay, guys, we are hyped. I'm hyped. That was
a good pun.
I'm so excited.
God damn it, Pat.
Here we go. So why do ships in Norway have barcodes on the side?
Why, Mickey?
Because when they come to port, they can Scandinavian.
Oh, yeah. See, we'll entertain that, but you make no comment about my versatiles.
Versatiles?
Versatiles.
What?
There'll be tiles with verses on them.
Nice.
What?
It was in the messenger. Yeah. Everybody ignored it. I must have
missed it. Oh, wait. That's it. Probably bye. All right, guys. We'll see you for episode 2.
See y'all.
Peace.
Episode 2, good season night. 3.
Peace.
Versatile.
But they have to be versatile also.
Well, exactly. They have to have, like, country, rap, and rock on the same way.
Our fans and our patrons, with all of your love and support, I feel trapped in all of this happiness. But thank you. You can check out our Patreon page for uncut reactions to this episode and more. See you next week.